Potential complications after liver transplant can generally be grouped into the following categories: problems with the blood vessel connections, the bile duct connection, related to medical conditions or medications. In addition to this, bleeding is a common occurrence in liver transplant. It may occur during the operation or in the first few days following the transplant, and it may require a return to the operating room to fix bleeding or remove blood clots. Liver disease itself makes people at increased risk for bleeding. One of the jobs of the liver is to make protein that helps the blood clot. It can take the new liver a bit of time to get back to normal levels of function. Blood transfusions at the time of transplant and in the few days after transplant are common. You may be at more risk for some complications than others based on your other medical problems or how ill you are at the time of transplant. We will review the other types of complications in more detail. Blood vessels are tubes that carry blood throughout the body. When we make connections between your blood vessels and the blood vessels of the new liver, I like to ask people to think of it like hooking two garden hoses together. Our goal is to allow blood to flow easily through the new connection from your body into the new liver and then back into your body. The blood vessels may become narrowed or kinked due to handling, the new connection, or positioning. If we have suspicion that the blood vessels are narrowed or kinked based on tests, we have several ways we approach this. Sometimes we use blood thinners to keep the blood from getting clogged in the narrowed area. Sometimes we place a straw or stent through the narrowing in order to prop it open and allow flow. On rare occasions, we have to return to the operating room to redo this connection. What we want to avoid or prevent from happening is blood cells getting stuck in the narrowing and leading to clogging or clotting of the blood vessel. If the blood vessel becomes completely clogged or clotted, it can cause the liver not to function. This happens infrequently, but may require that we perform a new transplant. Early retransplantation occurs infrequently, less than 5% of the time. Reasons for early retransplant include blood vessel complications and also a situation termed primary nonfunction. Primary nonfunction is a situation where, in spite of the liver looking acceptable on paper and in person, and the operation being fine, the liver does not function appropriately for reasons that we do not completely understand. In these situations, we do a new transplant as soon as possible. You may get a special status on the waiting list, placing you at the top of the waiting list. The bile duct is a tube that carries digestive fluid from the liver to the intestine. Complications with the duct include leaking or narrowing of the connection. If we have suspicion that there is a narrowing of this connection, we do a procedure called an ERCP. This procedure is similar to an EGD, where we use a video camera to look into your stomach. However, in an ERCP, we look further into the area of the intestine, which is connected to the liver. In an ERCP, the video camera views into the intestine and we look for any narrowing in the connection to the liver. If there is narrowing, temporary straws or tubes, like these blue tubes shown here, are placed into the duct to stretch the connection. In 6 to 8 weeks, the procedure is repeated. If the narrowing persists, the stents are replaced. If the narrowing has resolved, the stents are removed. In rare situations, we have to return to the operating room to fix an area of narrowing. After liver transplantation, you will take medications to prevent rejection for the rest of your life. These medications help protect your body from attacking the new liver and causing damage to it. The same cells that are weakened in order to protect the new liver are the cells that help protect our bodies from infection and guard against abnormal appearing cells. Because of this, these medications increase your risk of infection and cancer. The most common cancer following liver transplant is skin cancer, so it is important that you use sun protection after transplant and that you see a skin doctor once a year. There are some lifestyle changes that go along with transplant that are largely targeted at decreasing your exposure to infections. You will learn more about these during the evaluation process. Survival following transplant is very good, with the 1 year post-transplant survival being greater than 90%. Issues during the first year are largely related to the complications of surgery previously discussed, as well as infection. The 5 year post-transplant survival is 75 to 85% and may be affected by medical problems you have unrelated to transplant.